Hi, my name is Rachel. I'm a genetic counselor and I specialize in hereditary cancer. So I wanted to make this video to tell you about six important red flags that you should be aware of that may be in your family and that could suggest that your family has a hereditary cancer syndrome. So as I'm going through these red flags, you can think about your family history. Think back to your aunts and uncles, your grandparents, your cousins, and see if you see these red flags in your family, then you may benefit from genetic testing and genetic counseling. So before I go into the six red flags, I just wanted to say most cancer is not hereditary. About 90 to 95% of cancer is not hereditary. The most common cause of cancer is just aging. The aging process, every time our cells divide, there are mutations that accumulate and that can eventually lead to cancer. In addition to the aging process, a lifetime exposure to carcinogens such as UV radiation also increase the risk of cancer. Lifestyle choices such as smoking, alcohol use, living a sedentary lifestyle, all of those are risk factors for cancer. Only about 5 to 10% of cancer is actually due to a single gene mutation that is getting passed down through the generations and is increasing the risk of cancer. So this video is specifically about that 5 to 10%. What are some of the red flags that we may expect to see in a family with that rare hereditary cancer syndrome? So it's important to look at both sides of your family, both mother's side and father's side. A lot of people have this misconception that you can only inherit cancer from your mother's side of the family, but that's completely incorrect. You get half of your genes from your mom, half your genes from your dad. So definitely think about both sides of your family as I'm going through these red flags. Number one, do we see multiple generations affected by cancer? So if we see a grandparent, parent, and child, that is an important red flag that maybe there's something that is getting passed down through the generations and is causing all these people to have cancer. Number two, do we see multiple people on the same side of the family with the same type of cancer or related types of cancer? For example, if we see one case of colon cancer in the family, that's not super alarming. But if we see three cases of colon cancer in the same side of the family, that is unusual. Number three, do we see cancers happening at young ages, meaning under 50? So as we age, like I said, it's normal to see the risk of cancer increasing. But if we see cancers under age 50, that is the third red flag to be aware of. Number four, do we see any family members with more than one primary cancer? I'm not talking about a cancer that starts in the breast and then spreads to the lungs or liver. That would be called a metastasis. I'm really talking about two separate primaries. So for example, someone who has a breast cancer and then 5 years later develops an ovarian cancer. That is unusual and that's a red flag. Also, having bilateral cancer, such as bilateral breast cancer, goes under this category as well. The fifth red flag encompasses a couple of different tumor types. So the fifth red flag is, do you see specific types of cancers in your family? One important cancer to be aware of is triple negative breast cancer. So most breast cancer is estrogen and progesterone receptor positive and HER2 negative. That means that the tumor is fueled by hormones and it doesn't produce a protein called HER2. That's the most common scenario. It's not very common to have what we call triple negative breast cancer, meaning there are no estrogen receptors or progesterone receptors on the breast tumor cells, and there's no HER2 being produced. That's triple negative breast cancer. That's not very common, but among people who have a BRCA1 gene mutation or different genes as well can be associated with it, we do see a higher risk of triple negative. So triple negative breast cancer is one important cancer to be aware of that could be a red flag. Another important cancer to be aware of is male breast cancer. So about 1 in 1,000 men will develop breast cancer in their lifetime, so not very common at all. But when we do see a man with breast cancer, that is a red flag. About 18% of all male breast cancer is due to a hereditary cancer syndrome. Another tumor to be aware of is ovarian cancer, and this includes cancer of the fallopian tubes as well as primary peritoneal cancer. about 20 to 25% of ovarian cancer is due to a hereditary cancer syndrome, most commonly mutations in BRCA1 and BRCA2. Another cancer to be aware of is pancreatic cancer. About 10% of all pancreas cancer is due to a hereditary cancer syndrome, and specifically 4 to 7% of pancreas cancer is due to a mutation in either BRCA1 or BRCA2. And the last tumor to be aware of is metastatic or high-grade prostate cancer. So prostate cancer is very common in men. It's the second most common cancer after skin cancer. Prostate cancer is typically very slow growing, but if it's a hereditary cancer, it's a lot more likely to be high grade or metastatic. So that was number five. That was all the different specific tumors that you should look out for in your family. The last bullet point is ethnicity. Different ethnic groups may be at higher risks for certain genetic conditions. When we're talking about cancer, it's important to be aware of whether there's any Ashkenazi Jewish ancestry in your family, meaning are you of Eastern European Jewish descent, because Ashkenazi Jews have a 10 times higher risk of having a mutation in BRCA1 or 2, which is associated with hereditary breast and ovarian cancer. So as you're going through your family history and you're thinking about all of your relatives, if you see some of these red flags, and especially if you see multiple red flags, that could mean that there's a hereditary cancer syndrome in your family and that you may benefit from genetic testing. So I would recommend that you speak with your doctor about getting a referral to see a genetic specialist, and that could be a geneticist or a genetic counselor, to go over your medical history with them and your family history and see what kind of genetic testing may be indicated for you. Now, if you go through genetic testing and you're found to have a hereditary cancer syndrome, a genetic specialist would meet with you to go over your options for either increased screening to try to catch a cancer as early as possible, or talk to you about whether there's any medications that you can take to reduce your risk, or any preventative surgeries that you can take to reduce your risk. So in the description box below, I'm going to link to the National Society of Genetic Counselors. On their website, they have a cool feature where you can search for a genetic counselor near you. You can search by specialty, so you can find someone who specializes in cancer. You can search by zip code, and you can also search by whether you prefer to meet somebody in person or whether you prefer to meet a genetic counselor remotely, like by video or phone. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. That lets me know that you enjoyed this content. I do plan to make more videos like this. I plan to make it once a week. So if you'd like to be notified about these videos, just click the subscribe button. If you have any friends or family that you think would benefit from this information, feel free to share it. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.